Hey, Charles, how you doing?
I'm doing just fine, Michael. How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty well, thanks. I'm happy to get a chance to tell you about something today.
Excellent. And what is it you're going to tell me about?
We're going to talk about regression.
Like progression?
No, regression. So let me tell you about regression. So we are, in this section of the class, talking about supervised learning. And supervised learning, we're going to take examples of inputs and outputs. And based on that, we're going to be able to take a new input and predict the corresponding output for that input, right? So this covers all of the things that we're talking about in the context of supervised learning, right?
Right.
Now, what makes regression a special subtopic? We're going to be talking about mapping continuous inputs to outputs, as opposed to, what was the other thing that we were mapping? What other kinds of outputs did we think about?
Well, we had discrete outputs and continuous outputs.
Right, and so this is going to be the focus on continuous. So regression seems like sort of an odd word. It doesn't really kind of fit for this. Often I think about regression as, so this is me being all sad and sort of reverting back to a childhood state. And that's, you know, that's in the psychological sense, that's what regression refers to. But it turns out that that's not what it means in this setting. But the story by which those things became linked, I think, is kind of interesting. So let me tell you about that. Okay, so this is a picture of you, Charles.
Okay, I'll accept that.
You can tell it's you because he's really tall, and you're a fairly tall man. I know you don't think of yourself that way, but you think of everyone else as being short, which is really the same thing.
Fair enough.
All right, so let's say that this is Charles. Let's say that this is someone of average height, just someone at random.
Mm-hmm.
So now let's pretend, Charles, that you have children.
I do have children.
All right, so that's okay, but we can just pretend. And we want to ask the question, what would you expect the average height of your children to be? Would you expect it to be sort of, you know, sort of Charles height or average height or maybe somewhere in between? So let's actually ask this as a quiz.